Yes.
I'm very happy to be here with you in IBSC International Buddhist College Study at MCU in Thailand.
Same here.
Yes, and we are
good to be here.
Yeah, the graduate student MA class of Buddhist Studies. So my tradition is Mahayana. I'm from Vietnam.
Yes, and I'm Theravada.
Theravada.
From Thailand.
Which tradition that you follow in Thailand?
I am a traditional Theravada in Thailand, just like most of Buddhist monk over here.
So I am sitting with a Theravada Buddhist monk, Bante View. He's having been in England for 11 years and being a monk 7 years, and he decided to be a monk forever.
Eight years now.
8 years now. And he's my classmate. And we go for Amstrad every morning. Already 4 months.
We do. we've been together for about 2 months now, don't
two
we?
Months. Yeah,
2 months.
And we continue to finish within 2 years. And as I observe, he's a serious monk. He likes to practice rather than study. And he ever practiced in the forest. And he share his experience quite excited to me. Being a monk.
Yes.
What is the advantage? You think that as a human live a monastic life like a Buddhist monk, what is the use for?
Being a monk, the big advantage over lay people is that it is much easier for you to practicing Dhamma. Because when you want to practice Dhamma, you know, you have faith in Buddhist teaching. You've been going through studying a lot about how the Buddha become enlightened. And if you want to follow his teaching, you have to do it like all the way. You cannot do it halfway.
Diligently.
Yeah, being lay people is very, very, very difficult to do that. But if you leave home, become a monk, feeling that the dukkha is the problem in your life, and you see the Four Noble Truths as the way out. Being a monk, it helps you a lot in obtaining this enlightenment that the Buddha teach. So I decided, when they see the dukkha within daily life as lay people, and I thought, I'm not having any more of that. I'm trying to become enlightened. So that is it. I just, you know, leave home, leaving my family behind. And I thought, being a monk is great life and having a big advantage over it.
As your experience, your own experience.
My own experience. When I was lay people, I'm trying to become enlightened. I have this environment around me when I'm working and the people surrounding me. Not many people that have faith in Buddhism. So there is no one in the outside world that they try to encourage me to become enlightened. But when you become a monk, you are living in the community that everyone have faith in Buddhism. So everyone in the monkhood, they are trying to, you know, encourage each other to become enlightened. So this is a really big advantage for me.
Question is, yeah, thank you for your answer.
Yes.
I'm a monk too. And I think your answer is perfectly correct.
Okay.
That is the reason why we need Dharma friends.
Yes, Kalayanamita.
Kalayanamita. And the environment is called meditation center. And according to you, the most difficulty as a young monk we encounter?
The most difficulty as a young monk, for me, is my own heart actually. It's my own heart, my own mind, my own feeling. Because the environment that we have as monkhood in Thailand, because the people are really having faith in the Sangha. They believe in the Sangha a lot. It's much, you get really good support among Thai people, but what really difficult for me is that my mind keep going around and around, you know, thinking something outside, what is it like to go out there, go back out there, you know, having a wife, try to work, getting rich, having a car, having a nice girlfriend, something like that. I'm thinking sometimes, time to time, I'm not saying that I'm thinking a lot, but it can happen. But every time I think about it, then it's just not working out, you know, because my experience tell me it's not working out. And what difficult in the second step is the vinaya itself. You know, staying in the monk robe and then try to follow vinaya to become enlightened. I think the sangha these days, they don't actually follow the vinaya really well, like it used to be. Back to the time of Longpu Man or Longpu Cha, if you're reading the book about their biography, you can tell that back to the day, they follow the vinaya very strictly. But these days, because the environment, it doesn't really supporting you to follow the vinaya or that well anymore. So I think that is cutting you down from the step of trying to be, you know, enlightened, achieving your goal. So it's much more difficult that way. Because these days you're going everywhere, you know, you're seeing all this technology, there's good movie coming out, you want to see it, my mind going with the movie. There is a lot of pretty girls walking around, your mind going with the girl sometimes. Yeah. If you follow your vinaya too strictly, then it doesn't suit the modern day environment anymore.
Not strict, then we get away from enlightenment. But strictly, that difficult to deal with the modern society.
It is, yeah. Because this day, for example, like vinaya just said, you cannot carry money anymore. You're coming to study in IBSC. You need money, you know. You need to carry money. Okay. You need to use money to pay for your tuition fee and thing.
It's a reality. I accept that. And I think that is the truth. It's very difficult for monastic Buddhist monks and nuns to practice the Buddha teaching, aim at enlightenment in the modern world like today.
Yes.
With those difficulties as a young monk. What is your solution? When the mind running away from your body and the now, when your mind is out of the control, then how do you deal with
it? My basic technique is probably Kamadana.
Kamadana?
Yeah, Kamadana. Usually I'm doing Anapanasati, you know, Vipassana.
Yeah.
I'm staying on your breathing. You know, when you're thinking a lot, you stop breathing for a little while, for like hold it on for 10 seconds and then carry on breathing. I'm doing all sort of basic stuff, like trying to, we call Borikam, try to follow your breathing, carrying putto, in and out, in and out. Auto basic stuff is not try to follow your mind, you know. When your mind telling you one thing, and if you have sati with you, you know this is bad, then you're not going to follow it.
Wonderful.
Yeah, it really basic stuff. I'm not doing something complicated.
That means if we recognize the mind telling us something, that means we have sati.
Yes.
Sati, we recognize there is the mind with some stuff, and if that stuff lead us to the bad way, then we stop it. How to, you know, keep up or enhance our capacity of being mindful?
to enhance the capacity. Just have to do it regularly, diligently, you know, non-stop. If you, what I do find is that if you, sometimes if you get lazy, you know, don't do kompetana anymore for a few days, then you're not feeling well anymore. Because your mind starting wandering around, going somewhere. Try to get something to do, really. Something that righteously that the monks can do, like meditation, walking meditation, or if you get some time, then listening to Dhamma talk.
According to you, why is our human mind is always running, wander around? Why is it all the time we have thoughts in our mind?
Because our mind is so used to traveling around, you know.
Why?
For all the past, with every past life that we've been going through, our mind's been doing it for a lifetime and lifetime already.
It's practice every day, every lifestyle.
Yeah, it never actually that we can control our mind because anatta, you know. When your mind get attached to something, it's always going to go to that attachment. It never going to stick with you. So I think it's quite normal for your mind to go somewhere. But as long as you know that it's going somewhere, you have the state with you, then I think you wouldn't have much problem.
Wow, beautiful.
Yeah. You wouldn't have much problem because you know what's going on. You can't understand your mind.
That means we are not afraid of the mind wandering, but we only afraid of we have sati, do you recognize it or not?
Yes, yes. So you have to know what you are doing all the time. Otherwise, you know, you can go crazy over it. Or you can do something really bad over it.
Yeah, I get crazy quite sometimes.
Everyone can get crazy quite sometimes. It's not easy, you know.
That means your answer for the reason why our mind as human beings always think of something but never stop. The reason is that we attached, isn't it?
Yeah, attachment.
Attachment. So now it's still attachment, but we are able to be aware of our attachment. That's it. That is the capacity as human we can do, isn't it?
Yeah, basic capacity.
And we have to diligently practice of being aware of the attachment non-stop.
Yeah. And I think Vipassana is going to help us here. Eventually, if we keep practicing, maybe we can let go of the attachment, huh?
Oh.
Because in the past, someone like Ajahn Chah, Lung Pu Man, they will be teaching us this. If you carry on doing Vipassana, when your parami is full to its fullest, you will become enlightened and be able to let go of your attachment eventually. And I still believe that. I can't do it yet, but I think at the moment all I can do is that recognize what is going on with my mind. It's quite normal for my mind to going around.
In that way,
yeah.
For example, when your mind get trouble, for example, you get suffer because someone blamed you, or something that you unsatisfied with. How are you going to deal with?
Oh.
Okay, someone blame you.
Someone blame me, and I can get really upset sometime.
Then, how do you cope with that?
The first thing first, I'm gonna have to try to understand them. Why do they get angry with me?
Find the reason.
The reason, yeah.
Reason.
Usually, it's not really me that causing a problem. Yeah, the problem is really basic. To the foundation of the four noble truth. It is someone mind or someone attachment. or their desire, the wanting that, wanting this, they're causing them to have an anger with me. So it's not really myself that causing them anger. If I can understand it this way, I'm feeling better.
That means you apply the Buddha teachings as the Fourth Noble Truth into that event.
Yes. Yes.
Find out the cause.
Yeah, find out the cause. And then to solve it, properly obey Ka is the best.
Obey
if, Ka. Yeah, if we can explain to them.
Let it go.
Yeah, if we can let go, I let go. And if we can explain to them what is going on, if we can make understanding between each other, I would do that. But if we can't do it, then you know you have to let it go. You cannot satisfy everybody. You have to accept them as who they are. You know, if they don't like you, they don't like you, you know. You cannot change, you know, chicken into the cow. You cannot change the bird into the chicken. We are who we are.
I think the way to let go is to accept who they are, isn't it?
Yeah, there's one way to let go.
Because we have no power or we have no right to expect something or someone to follow the way we want.
Yeah, we cannot control even our own mind. We cannot control it.
Beautiful.
Then who are we going to control their mind? You know what I mean?
Beautiful sentence.
Other people, they have their own thinking. They have their own problem in life. And most of the time, we don't even know them. If they get angry, then we know that we are not the cause of the problem. The real problem is themselves.
Ah.
Yeah. As long as you don't have any intention to make them angry, you know, you don't have any bad intention to cause a problem for them,
but if sometimes
they should be fine.
Sometimes we have a good intention, but they still suffer because of our good intention. Then,
If you have good intention, you should be okay. But if you have bad intention, then that could really cause you problem. I think with good intention. And then we have a problem with that. If someone got angry with me, I can understand myself. I can understand them. Then there wouldn't be a problem. But what really causing me a trouble, if I have bad intention.
Bad intention.
Like if I'm angry with someone, I want to hurt them. I want to do something bad to them. Before I do that, I know I'm in trouble already. That's how I feel because I'm really feeling hot inside, you know. It's kind of like burning up my mind. And everything,
yeah.
I can't stop thinking about it. Yeah. If we're going through with it, like if we go to hurt them, when I was a teenager, I done that before. Then it really become, you know, a long series of conflict. Can we go on and on?
Oh.
And I know I'm in trouble for that. So good intention is not a problem. The problem is bad intention.
The intention is the key.
Yeah.
Okay, like today, we're going to have lunch. If your mind is not stable and unsatisfied with someone or something, you're going to have lunch or you just quit lunch and sit down thinking. Which one do you choose? For example, you got suffering so much,
yeah.
But now you go and you have lunch. You will have lunch or you stop eating lunch.
I can't say I would have lunch, and I can't say I would not go to have lunch. With lunch, if I'm hungry, I would go to have lunch, you know. If I'm not hungry, I would not go to have lunch. So lunch is not really the answer to dealing with this sort of problem.
Okay.
If I can let go of this, then I would do what my heart decides to do, as long as it's not cause a problem. Maybe if if you feel hungry, I will go to eat. If you're not feeling hungry, then I wouldn't go to eat.
Sometimes when we get sad so much, we cannot eat because we're full of sadness in our stomach.
Sometimes, yes, you can sometimes. Be sad sometimes, you know.
Have you ever you're so sad
Yeah.
That you are not able to eat lunch even.
Yeah.
Ever? Sometimes?
I have, yeah. I have been through that situation when I was lay people. I was so sad that I cannot eat.
Yeah.
But one thing I do know, this sadness will not stay with me for long. So if I can understand it that way,
how
I can cope with it.
How long?
Usually like 2-3 days.
Well, quite long.
Yeah, it's quite a long time. Sometimes. When I was a teenager, when I was a lay people, sometimes, you know, maybe you get heartbroken. That's one example. You're feeling sad. And even if you try to eat, you cannot eat.
Yeah, I know.
If that happen, just let your sadness flowing with you sometime without trying to control it.
Wow.
Because if you try to control it, it can really make you crazy, you know?
Really?
So I would say if you get angry,
let it flow.
You can flow with your angry sometime, but just don't get lost in it. If you cry, let yourself cry sometime, just don't get lost in it. If you're sad, just let yourself sad sometime, but don't go on and on.
Then how long?
Try to lose in it.
How long should we go on?
For me, naturally, it's only flowing for maybe a few days, from few hours to a few days. Then that go on. But if you have the cause that originate your problem, don't go back to the cause of the problem.
Oh.
Try to stay from your problem. And ubeka in your mind, you know, let go in your mind and stay away from the cause of problem.
Oh.
Maybe it's the person, maybe it's object, maybe it's work. Well, you probably cannot take a break from work, but you can deal with it. Maybe find a new job and other things like that. But with the person, it's not so hard. You can stay away from them.
Oh, nice.
If it's an object that cause you problem, you can let go quite quickly. Like sometimes you break your stuff and you feel sad.
with the sadness and the suffering within, the first thing is we let it flow, but the second thing, we do not go back into the source or the cause to think all the time. If we think of the cause causing suffering, then we cannot stop suffering, isn't it? Let the present suffering flows, but we have to stop thinking of the cause causing of suffering.
Yeah. Just make sure you have sati, you know. As long as you know what's going on, then it cannot harm you. You know, everyone can be sad sometimes.
But when we sad or we feel suffer, usually our mind wants to explain that we are right and others wrong. Then how we are able to stop that kind of trace back of the thinking want to be right? They all the time want to be right when we suffer. Then how to stop that one? How to stop the wanting want to be right for other to be wrong and for us to be more suffer?
I wouldn't have time to stop it. Because naturally human or the human being, you know, we grow up. We get this teaching in your life. This is right and this is wrong. So we become attached over time, you know.
Right and wrong.
Yeah, right and wrong. There is right and wrong. In reality, there is no right and wrong.
In reality, no right and wrong.
Yeah. But because we are so attached to it, we have to understand that our mind are attached to right and wrong. If we can understand that, then we can let go of it easier. You know, just let it flow. And if you understand it, there's another way to let go, I think.
I mean, when we understand there is no right and wrong, then no need, the necessary to be right.
Yeah.
So, no right, then no suffer, I think. Because the ego wants to be right.
Yeah.
Then the right will make the ego as the victim. And
yes.
And other is the cause. Causing the victim is mine.
Yes.
So, as long as we still keep the ego and the right, the suffering is still there, I think. Isn't it?
It have to be there until we become enlightened, I think. Until we reach, you know, arahantship. we're still going to suffer again and again, you know, over time.
That means until you get enlightenment,
yeah,
suffering still there. We yeah. cannot run away from suffering, but the way we deal with that is different by awareness of sati, of cessation, yeah. isn't it?
At the moment, we just have to stay mindful.
That's it.
You know, use mindfulness, yeah. dealing with all these things. Suffering. Have understand that it's quite normal. That something like this can happen.
Suffering is there.
Yeah.
Never stop until we get enlightenment.
Yeah.
But what we can do with sati here?
Yes.
Observe it.
Yeah.
What is going on, we clearly know.
Yeah.
Recognize it.
Yes.
Then everything is safe.
Yeah.
In our hands, control.
Yeah.
That's the way. That is your method to live. To deal with the difficulties in your monastic monk's life.
Yes,
it's
it is.
It's wonderful, Bante, for your sharing today. Learn a lot sincerely, and okay. I think we will benefit for our friends listening.
Well, thank you very much.
Yeah, sadhu,
okay, thank you for your interview also.
Yes, yeah, sadhu.